Yesterday on the program, we start talking about Fani Willis, and it looked like she had a really bad day on the stand, and we weren't the only ones who thought that. Almost everybody did, and MSNBC, which normally protects Democrats, that's the business they're in, we tell you that all the time. Can't even their legal analyst said, "Oh, that was pretty terrible." Now listen to what they said yesterday and what I said at the end of that clip. Then I'm going to come back and show you what they said this morning.
Now we know that MSNBC is notoriously in favor of the Democrats, provides cover for the Democrats, endless, nonstop anti-Trump content. But even with that in mind, here's how one of their analysts looked at the case today and commented on it.
This is epic. This is monumental. If things are going in the direction we think, Fani Willis lied to the court, it's game over for her. She will be disqualified. If they had a relationship prior to when they represented to the court, it's a huge deal. I can't overstate it.
Look, with MSNBC, you never know. They might be out. Because what happens on cable news is that when news breaks, someone will accidentally be human and tell you something that's true.
True, yes.
And then by the next morning, Scarborough's team will be out there going, "No, you really, you gotta remember Joy Reid, etc. You gotta defend Fani Willis here. Fani Willis is good." Now, Scarborough's team includes, of course, his co-host Mika Brzezinski. So let's see what she did this morning.
It's so interesting because you could definitely get from her testimony, Lisa, that she was angry for a number of reasons, and many of them she didn't bring up. She obviously doesn't like being lied about. She obviously doesn't like having her personal life dragged out into the open and also lied about. She mentioned several times in her testimony that she's had to move a lot because of death threats, even before the election trial began, because of other trials that she's presided over. I mean, this has been a tough job for her. And then to hear, you know, this sideshow happen to try and delay the election interference case, this is her point of view. She was just, you know what, absolutely PO'd and got up on the stand because she was like, "Damn it, I'm just going to have to tell my own story to these people." Let's talk about these people. The Trump attorneys seemed bumbling. They seemed unprepared. They seemed completely surprised that she took the stand and had absolutely nothing prepared for her.
Told you. Okay, so yesterday their legal analyst watches it and says that was devastating against Fani Willis, and the other side seemed to prove their point really well. This morning, they've got the talking points in order now. No, it turns out Fani Willis was lied about. She's the victim. She has such a tough job. And the other side is a bunch of bumblers who had nothing at all, okay? Funny how that turned around overnight. And you could have different opinions on whether Fani Willis actually hired her boyfriend and whether they were going out at the same time. And I think it's a little bit closer than either the legal analyst or Mika's making out to be. But Mika's not done yet, so watch one more.
This election interference trial has caused a danger to her life. So if you're wondering why she's angry, is that this has led to such an upheaval in her life in so many different ways to serve and to try and take this case to fruition, and then to have this happen, that would cause someone to be very, very angry. I know I'm going to get to a question, but I just want to point out, you know, it's bad when you turn on Fox News and they start talking about her demeanor, her behavior, her looks. I mean, it shows that there's probably a problem with the case that they think they have against her. I thought she was fiery. I thought she said important things.
She said important things. Yesterday we were telling you that it seemed like she was lying when a legal analyst was being honest for a second. Now all of a sudden we're turning around and say she's being lied about. She's the victim. And they're making comments about her appearance. That's not the issue, okay? But look, there's two reasons why we're telling you this. Number one, let's be honest, hashtag Cenk was right, okay? Okay, now in all seriousness, guys, there's a real point in here. Now, why do we show you our predictions and then show you them actually coming to fruition? Not to brag, but so that you guys know that this is predictable. when you have an agenda and you're not doing actual news, you will always go back to that agenda. So no matter what happens, and it's not just MSNBC. We've shown you this on Fox News too. A live event happens, someone is human for a second, goes, oh man, Trump looks really bad, right? And then by the next morning, they've recalibrated, they've got their new talking points. Trump looked fiery and fantastic, and that was just him being passionate, right? So they all do this, and I'm sick of it. None of them are in the news business. They're all in the propaganda business. It's just different people that they're doing propaganda for. All right, Ray, what do you think?
I felt like I was losing my mind when she said, well, you look at the coverage on Fox News and they're just talking about her demeanor. And then she just immediately starts talking about her demeanor just positively. You're doing literally the exact same thing. And I would bet my bottom dollar that a majority of the MSNBC audience and all of the Fox News audience, they have no idea that this is a motion hearing over whether or not she unjustly enriched herself. Because they're not talking about that. And if you act like if you want to say that their attorneys for the defense were bumbling, you could actually point to the fact that they presented very little substantive evidence to suggest that she did or even attempted to unjustly enrich herself, regardless of how you feel about the potential misconduct of the relationship. I mean, but that's not necessarily the goal of the defense's attorneys. Their goal is to create this, you know, circus. Their goal is to discredit Fani Willis as a prosecutor. And they're doing it successfully, and partially because mainstream, even mainstream, I don't want to call them left-wing media, because I don't think that's entirely accurate. But you know, these Democrats supporting mainstream media entities aren't even covering it in a meaningful way. They're covering it in a way that plays exactly into what the defense attorneys are hoping they will, in a way that we're not talking about substantively whether or not there was an argument presented to show that she had somehow unjustly enriched herself. We're talking about, you know, some slay queen girl boss bull about her demeanor on the stand, and then complaining that the other side is doing it in a way that just didn't paint her in a good light. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, Ray. Yeah, I'll just say one quick thing about that. You're so right, because they're not talking about the issue. They're talking about, are you pro Fani Willis or anti Fani Willis? Are you pro Trump or anti Trump? Yes, but brothers and sisters, concentrate. What did they do or not do? And it's amazing how little they care about that, Jackson.
Well, I think it's what you pointed out about, are you pro or anti Fani Willis, or are you pro or anti Trump? Things always get boiled down to be that simple, especially with the right wing, because if not, then how could you not have turned away from Trump at this point, given the fact that pretty much any other Republican is like, well, 98, 97, maybe 89% on board with his policies that they voted with him while he was in office. So it really is just the, you know, dumb brute analogy of this is my sports team versus yours. But that really kind of felt like we were watching The View or something, or some type of like gossip talk show where they were just defending their friend, like how Ray pointed out, kind of like the girl boss type of thing. But at the end of the day, I mean, this seems like a situation that Fani didn't really need to be in. I mean, this seems to have been something that is avoidable. So, and unfortunately, this is one of the more important cases, one of the more important criminal cases for Donald Trump. One of the ones that holds the most weight that people are really looking at. So it's unfortunate that this has to happen with this one, but I mean, this is a result of her action, so it is what it is.
See, that's a fair way of handling it, right? Saying, hey, I think that all three of us think that Trump did it, right? Based on the publicly available evidence. But that doesn't mean you should hire your boyfriend. But we don't know if they were boyfriend, girlfriend at the time, and you saw some conflicting testimony. I had the sense that they probably were going out earlier, and that it was probably wrong of Fani Willis to bring him onto the case. There's tons of lawyers in Atlanta. You didn't have to hire that one guy. But you know, others have defended her in a way that was substantive and interesting, where, you know, talk about the culture of keeping cash in your house, and it might depend on, you know, your background, etc. And she made it a spirited defense. But guys, that's not the point. The point is, are you analyzing the actual issue and trying to bring people real news in a way that's honest? Or are you just picking sides and then twisting the news and the truth to fit your agenda and what you want to do marketing for.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.